Hello, my name's Mark Fraser. I'm the teaching and learning lead at KEM. And today I'm talking to Kate Bailey, Director of Policy at KEM, about how you can use KEM data to support learning outcomes for your students. Kate, I'm just wondering maybe if you could just say a few words about yourself and the work you do at KEM.
Yeah, that's great. Thanks, Mark. I'm Director of Policy and Business Development. I've worked in KEM for over 20 years now, talking to schools and school leaders and ministries about how they can use KEM data to realise the school improvement. And so hopefully I can share some of that insight with you today.
Great, thank you. So just to first of all, just I wonder if you could tell us quite briefly, how can we use KEM data and what does the research say about the impact that data may have on student outcomes?
Yeah, that's a really interesting question. In education, we're a little bit behind the curve when it comes to using data. So in commerce and in medicine and health, data has been part of decision making for a long time, and we are starting to catch up with that now. So there's quite a lot of research studies going on the impact that data can have on good decision making. And obviously, ultimately, you want to know, does that good decision making impact on student outcomes at the end of it? And actually, there's not a lot of evidence around there to support that yet. And part of the reason for that is it's a very complex thing to understand. So you can have the best data in the world, but if it's not supported by engagement of your teachers and by a good school culture and good leadership, then you're not going to see the impact of that. It doesn't matter how good the data is, you won't see the impact of it. So trying to develop studies which unpick all of those different factors is quite difficult. But what we can say is that as an individual teacher or school leader, if you can focus very clearly on a problem you want to solve or something that you want to impact on, and then look at your data and understand it as tightly as you can to that question that you've got in mind, then that's the best way you're going to get impact out of that data.
Great. So I think you've said two quite interesting things there. You've picked up on the use of data by teachers, but also school leaders as well. So maybe firstly, if you're a teacher, how can you use KEM data to inform your planning for the future learning of your students?
Yeah. So the kind of data that we provide gives teachers some really valuable insight right at the beginning of a course of study or a phase of education when they won't know those students very well yet in most cases. And so this information can get into their hands straight away and start reflecting to them what the individual student's strengths and weaknesses are. And that will help them plan for the future, help plan what early interventions might need to be put in place to help students achieve their best. But also it gives you a really good idea of what the future potential, what the potential for those students are, potential for their learning outcomes, for you as a teacher, what pattern of results you would expect to see across your class for or across a subject. So what we do is we use data from 30 years of experience of assessing millions of children to understand the relationship between our baseline test score and later outcomes. So those outcomes might be GCSE, IGCSE, A-level IB. And by having that information, we are able to present back to teachers information on the likelihood of each student getting each available grade. It's not saying this is what's going to happen. What it's saying is, based on previous experience, this is what we've seen in the past. You have that information to help guide you in setting realistic but ambitious targets. And we know that the key to it is setting those ambitious targets, getting everybody to achieve what's best for them, but also having a strong evidence base to fall back on. So our information really makes that a possibility for teachers.
Great. Thank you. So thinking more from a school leadership and management point of view, what might they be able to do with KEM data?
Yep, that's good. So as I mentioned before, having the information there for teachers straight away gives them a good way of understanding what's there, what the potential is for them, what they need to work with to get those good results. But when it becomes really powerful is when it's built into a whole school self-evaluation. And so for school leaders, what they're going to be looking at is what were those predicted grade outcomes at the start of the period of study? What exam results did the students go on to achieve? And how much progress was made between those two time points? Now, this is absolute gold dust in terms of information for leaders. And the fact that it's confidential information means that it's okay if things aren't great. You know, in some cases, as we know, there'll be great amounts of progress made and people will, teachers and students will go on to achieve way above what was predicted for them. But that doesn't always happen. And that's okay, as long as we understand what might have gone wrong, what we can do differently next time, and then continue that cycle of baselining, gathering outcomes, working out what works and what doesn't, and really genuinely putting kind of a cycle of improvement in place. And our data is gold dust for school leaders in supporting that kind of activity.
Fantastic. Well, thanks very much for that, Kate, for the insight into how we might be able to use CHEM data to make a difference in schools. So thanks for listening, everybody. If you want to find out more, please visit chem.org and you can see a range of blog posts and other information and things describing our systems and how you can use them to make a difference using actionable information in your school. Thanks again.